Happy New Year!
Hey there, how was doing? This is Kali from Techfanciers. Well, we moved to Android 10 or Q, whatever, and just let you know that, guys, that this series started from Android 7, 7.1, 8, 8.1, 9, and now 10. This is 23rd episode of in-depth look. So as like earlier, we have installed the AOSP version 2.07, which is pretty latest. I have using this for a week. Earlier I have using AOSP 2.06, that also ended 10. So we all know about AOSP, it's vanilla version of Android and used as a base for all the custom ROM development or GSI development. That's a good start. So let's we take an in-depth look. First we start with the build details. This is latest official AOSP version 2.07 GSI from Fusion. It comes with the latest security patch 5th of December. Also the build date is 16/12/2019. The recent 2 build have some good improvements like Oreo vendor support, hotspot issue fixes and glitch fixes. Those fixes made this one pretty close to stable. And also I was wondering when this one start to work on Oreo vendor without any issues. Yes, you can boot this on Oreo vendor, which is ARM64A only partition. This partitions varies from device to device, so yeah, that's what. Here I am using Asus Zenfone Lite L1, which is triple supported device. Also I am using AOSP with the G apps included. I recommend you to use the same as well. Now we see the changes from the upgrades. Of course, the number update from Android 9 Pie to Android 10 Q. Some of the features that I needed to mention are, first one, the dark mode. It's not just a setting dark mode, it also works on status bar and some other apps like phone messages, but you need to enable it manually sometimes. Second, the volume slider. Unlike earlier one, here you can control all the volumes from the screen itself. No need to go to inside the settings. Third, new gestures. Gestures have been changed from quick switch of pill to slide one. It's smooth and wonderful. Switching between apps made really easy. Also, I like the go back gesture. That's really great. However, how much it is great, that much it is critical whenever you try to get the slide menu. To be honest, I like the Oxygen OS back button gesture where we can swipe the corner to get back. That was good. Anyway, you still have the Android Pie gesture. You can change it if you want. Fourth, styles and wallpapers. In Android 10, they have included a new wallpaper app which comes with some cool wallpapers like this moon one. Also this one, I like it really, I like it, I don't know. The fifth one, user interface, which is UI. I kind of like the status bar UI, which is clean and little rounder. That's looking really good. Also I have noticed that you can even seek the song directly through the status bar, which is really insane. Sixth one, the new sound recorder. Yes, the cool new sound recorder which transcripts the audio to text in live. It's actually cool. The seventh, new privacy option. The privacy option, this lets you to or where you can get the control of all the permission which apps are accessing. You can sort them with a type of usage. Eighth, new digital well-being. The all new digital well-being with the parental control lets you to view or monitor your children activity on the phone. Here it is not working, but yeah, you have it. And the focus mode where you can take the list of distracting apps and let them suffer. Yeah. a ninth one, camera. Here it is actually AOSP camera. It's working. Also, I have installed the Gcam and open camera, both are working like a charm, no issues. And the 10th one, performance. While comparing to Android 9 to Android 10, the performance was way more improved in terms of visual and experience. It seems like more fluid. So, but here it is not working that much great. What else? I have missed anything? Let me know in the comments. Now we come to the issue and problems of this build. And as you know, the problem that are faced by me mostly applicable only for the device, which is Asus Zenfone Lite L1. If you have some other device, you won't even face these issues. Or if you have a patch, well, you are good to go. So first one, the VoLTE. The VoLTE won't work here as we have no patch that works in Android 10. People are working on it, we'll find the solution soon. Second one, the battery. The battery is not so optimized, it's giving 3 to max 4 hours of screen on time. Also, even if I'm using or not, it just drains the battery in the background. I can fix those issues by using some Magisk module, but this is the reality, it drains, it just drains. In 3 days, even if you are not using the device, it drains the battery, even if you are not using the device. In 3 days, if you are using, well, you will get 6 to 12 hours. Third, uncertified system error. You will most probably face the uncertified system error on the FRP. So you have to install the patch and Magisk manager along with the GSI to encounter the issue. I have linked both the things in the description. You can check them. Fourth one, the super shoe. Basically, the AOSP builds comes with the shoe installer in built in, so that just ruin your safety net certification. Then you will end up with, I don't want to tell that. Yes, that is. Fifth one, as usual errors like low media volume, poor background app management, and auto brightness. Merry Christmas, filthy animal. Are still not working and still those issues are persist. And just to let you know that the default ringtone setter is not working, so you need to use the third party file manager like Solid Explorer to set the ringtone or notification tone. So yeah, that's what about this video. I will posting the tutorial of how to install Android 10 on Wario vendor soon, so you can watch and install the same. Well, conclusion. As always, I don't recommend you to use plain vanilla AOSP, so this is not recommended as we have cooler than this one in upcoming days. So that's what about this video. Leave a like to show your support and subscribe to this channel to keep in touch of new updates. So thank you for watching. Code Motor.